Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to bring you to go through the process of balancing your horn rods and your pistons. First and foremost, I need to tell you guys what is the reason of doing this balancing the weight for your horn rods and for your pistons. Alright, because all of them, be it a 4-cylinder, 6-cylinder, 8-cylinder or V configuration, you need to have them balanced so that when they are pushed up and down or when they are rotating, all of them are balanced each other out and reduce vibrations to your engine. Okay, this is especially important when you are chasing after high horsepowers or you want reliability for your engine. Alright, but we need to understand that horn rods and pistons, both of them are not moving the same direction, so we need to be very clear. Alright, so if you can see this rough sketch, okay, the piston rings, piston pins, and even the small end of the horn rod, they are moving up and down. Okay, the pistons moving up and down. Okay, so this one is, we call it the reciprocating motion. But the big end of the horn rod, which is attached to the crankshaft, it is rotating. Okay, so these two is different is because, okay, rotational, if it is not balanced, it is not as important as the reciprocating part, which is not balanced. Okay, so you need to make sure that the reciprocating part are balanced out, okay, so that it will have lesser vibration and we can go for higher horsepower application. Alright, before I'm going to start this video, I'm going to give a big shout out to my ex-student, okay, who is Alif. Okay, he is a very talented drawer, and then this clothes is his design, you see. Alright, so if you guys want to buy his apparels, you can check out in the link in the description. Okay, because he is a very very talented person and he really likes automotive and he likes drawing, he combined these two together. Alright guys, today I just got my weighing machine, weighing scale. This one is from eBay. It's for 1000 gram, and then it can go up to 0.1 gram in sensitivity. So I hope this one doesn't lie to me. So I just have to believe this as true for all my measurements, and then I just use this machine, this scale to see whether I can balance out all my horn rod and pistons. Alright, so I already put marks on the horn rod, so I am going to write down all their weight, all their individual weight. Almost cheating, 799.7 gram. Alright, and please take note that I have already lightly oiled them so that it won't rust so much, but most of them are really really close to each other. 799.9 gram, the third one. Oh my god, so near to each other. 799.5 gram. Okay, all of these readings I'm going to tack twice. Okay, and then I'm going to trim off this surface so that I can have some.
not so sensitive, I guess, because some of the oil was left over here, but it doesn't detect any weight. Right, number 4 and 5. So near to each other, 799.5 grams. The last one. Wow, so near to each other, 799.6 grams. Okay, I'm going to do second measurement. See whether they're consistent. Okay, so I got all the reading already. Here it is.
Alright, I want to share with you guys the story of how did I get these corn rods. Alright, this corn rods is taken out from my car from Kuala Lumpur, which is Kuda Perkasan. Okay, this corn rods has already been balanced by the previous tuner, okay, which is called Along Raceworks. Alright, so I'm going to give a big shout out to him because he has done a very good job in balancing these corn rods. I double checked the corn rod, the big end has already been filed down, okay, to the nearest grams, so that all six of them are very balanced to each other. That is why he is able to make good horsepower with reliability.
Now I'm going to measure the piston weight. The first one is so significantly heavier than the rest. The rest is about 530. So I'm going to double check the first piston ring.
Okay, I'm going to skip the piston weight measurements. But what I did was, I put all the components in, all the piston rings and the piston pin. Okay, that's what I did the first time. But after that, I measured there's such a huge big gap between the first piston and the rest. I took out the piston rings and the piston pin to measure. But sadly that all the piston pins and piston rings are balanced. So that's why I cannot do the mix and match with the piston number one, so that I can do lesser work in grinding down the materials of the first piston.
Alright, so this is the six readings that I got from. So it deviates not so much, so probably there are some stains stuck on the weighing machine, but I think it is very close. But what I'm saying, what I'm worrying about is the difference between all these. The first one is significantly heavier than others, so I'm going to do something about it. Hi, hello guys. Now I'm having this overweight piston by 4 grams, so which is a lot, so I'm going to grind it. So I'm going to select a place for me to grind. I need to take note of a few things. First is I need to do small increments so that I always do very very little bit of grinding, and I do the weighing. I always do this so that I won't over grind the piston and then I have to regrind the rest of the pistons. Alright, then the second thing to take note is we try to leave as smooth surface as possible so that it won't give any stress riser or heat riser points, such as sharp points or accumulated a hole. Okay, we don't want to reduce the strength of the piston. Okay. The third thing is we don't want to remove any material from the side, because this is the place where to seal all the combustion air, the combustion mixture. Okay, so we don't want to grind anywhere at the sides or at the top. If we are grinding at the top, we may reduce the compression ratio, and then the compression won't be the same for the rest of the pistons. Alright, so what we can do is we look from here. Okay, because this one is the original piston, you can see different pistons, you can see they have their own places where you can actually try to remove some of the material, excess material. But over here in the original piston, there seems like very hard to find places. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to remove here. Okay, there's one sharp point which I think doesn't serve any purpose. Alright, and then over here, I'm going to do a chamfer. Okay, and let's see how much I can save.
Alright, so here's the thing that I've done that most of the tuners may not agree, but I'm going to do it in the name of science! Yes!
Okay, I think I barely saved 0.1 gram. So I'm going to continue and find more places. I'm going to continue to do the chamfers also. Alright, let's get to it. Okay, I'm going to recheck my weight. Just to double check, this one is 132. Okay, correct. So I'm going to weigh everything. So I managed to reduce 0.2 gram. So let's skip the 3 grams, okay? Okay guys, I've already done a lot, but still only removed 0.4 grams of weight from this piston. So I'm going to do some drastic measure. And then I saw this, there's a Toyota logo over here, the part number, the Toyota wording here. I'm going to grind this one off, okay, because I think that one doesn't serve any purpose. Okay, and then the thickness is it doesn't have any compensation over here, so I think this one can be removed also. And then let's see whether I can do 1 gram or something. Oh, after so many work, I've already done here, and the wordings for the Toyota, no more wordings, but I only managed to reduce by 1 gram. So I'm going to I noticed that over here, if you can see carefully, there are 2 holes here. Actually, they are like oil passage, so allow the oil to go through. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to drill here, and then I'm going to grind here also, because over here is just to allow the oil to go through, and then it doesn't provide any additional strength or support for the piston itself. So I'm going to make it slightly thinner, and hopefully I will get the target 3 grams. Alright.
So stay tuned, and I'm going to show you guys the result of this project to Jay-Z, and let's look forward to it. Alright, that's all for today, and comment below if you guys got any question, and please consider to subscribe if you guys want more info into Jay-Z tuning. See you!